Do you sleep face down? Most men have never been asked that question, but I will, because sleeping position can quietly wreck emotions, desire, and morning confidence. Medicine has a blind spot. It's called sleep. We spend a third of our lives in bed. Most doctors act like the night doesn't matter. It does. What happens in the dark rides your daylight. This is why I always ask my patients about sleep. It's part of the UroChannel algorithm, a special framework for assessing sexual dysfunction holistically. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, one of the most copied urologists on YouTube. AI slop channels especially love my content because it reflects something fake doctors don't have: clinical experience. Let's quickly repeat why sleep is crucial for sexual function. Start with the engine, REM sleep. Rapid eye movement. Several times per night, your eyes flick left and right while your body relaxes. That's when emotions are processed, memory resets, hormones fine-tune, and the limbic system, the home of libido, gets serviced. Erections show up there too. Think of the penis as a free diver, holding its breath by day, then refueling at night. Those nocturnal erections are oxygen supply. Kill REM and you interrupt maintenance. But what if you don't know whether you even have nighttime erections because you're asleep? In the next video, I'll show you exactly how to find out. So subscribe and don't miss it. Now the uncomfortable part. The prone position compresses chest, abdomen, and pelvis. It tilts the pelvis forward, tightens the pelvic floor, and restricts free breathing. Micro-arousals follow, even if you never remember them. Each one spikes sympathetic tone, the daytime fight or flight mode that should be sleeping. Result? Fragmented REM, fewer and weaker night erections, and over months a slow drift toward erectile trouble and low desire. Testosterone? Important, yes. But testosterone is the gas. REM is the engine. If structure and regulation are off, more gas won't make the car start. That's why some men on perfect labs still feel flat. So what should you do tonight? First, protect REM like a precious gem. Aim for 7 hours, lights out at roughly the same time. Keep the phone out of your face. Blue light before bed is a REM thief. Skip the nightcap. Alcohol trades quick drowsiness for shattered sleep. If you grind your teeth, talk to your dentist. Nocturnal jaw tension causes micro-arousals, just like snoring. Second, change the geometry. The second best position is flat on your back. Neutral pelvis, free breathing. If your lower back complains, put a pillow under the knees. The best option is your left side. That frees heart and diaphragm, improves fluid drainage, keeps the pelvis neutral, reduces reflux risk, and gives the vagus, the master of calm, room to work. Third, if you are unable to breathe during sleep, even the best of all sleeping positions won't help you. Being male, being over 50, and being overweight are risk factors. It means your throat muscles collapse during sleep. You then simply can't breathe. It causes a lot of trouble in your body, affecting your heart, and eventually leaving you in a state of chronic inflammation. No penis wants to rise after that treatment. So here's a rule of the UroChannel algorithm. Protect the night, and the day improves. Better sleep architecture means stronger REM, which gives you reliable nocturnal erections, preserved tissue oxygenation, and better daytime performance. It's a loop you can influence. If this reframed your nights, subscribe to UroChannel and like this video. It's the digital equivalent of nighttime erections, small actions that sustain the system. Want the deep dive on sleep, pelvic floor tension, and why the left side beats the right? It's coming in the next episode of Urology Noire. Turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Quick self-check. Did you wake with at least one spontaneous erection this week? That's your nightly health report. Improving mornings mean your system is recovering. Flat mornings for weeks? That's a signal, not a verdict. Bring the data to your doctor. We'll fix the structure first, then adjust hormones if needed. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.